Okay, hello guys. In this video, we'll demo about we using the Revive.js service for AngularJS applications. So let me demo. We press this button, it will load. Actually, it will call Revive.js to load data for us. And when load successfully, we will set the data. So how it works? Let's look at the code. Here is the rand.js and here is the code of main our application. So we have the load data and this show rand here. Our controller will have scope.rand and will load data. We actually call rewind and when a load data successfully we will call the new rand. So when you load Revive.js module, Revive.js load the target JavaRib file asynchronous before enroll the convert asynchronous. This asynchronous nature means that your Revive.js convert will invoke outside the AngularJS lifecycle. As such, you have to explicitly call the apply within your convert so that AngularJS will probably your asynchronous chain throughout the rest of application to encapsulation requirement. No, we rely a Revive.js that simply receives the Revive function and take care of calling scope.apply within the convert. Not only does this turn the global Revive.js referency to AngularJS injectable, it also leaves your Revive statement tree of necessary lifecycle groups. So to see this in action, we have load.js here. So actually the rewind here is our service in AngularJS, it's ArcRoc. So rewind.js module will test the control load outside the module AngularJS context. We need to create a roc that will automatically Alex AngularJS to execution of the convert. Let this give us opportunity to add some error handling. So when rewind, so here is the rewind happen of the Revive.js. So when successful, we need to add our asynchronous add this data to the git cycle, so it allow we update the our model. So you can see the rewind service is rather straightforward. It simply call the call rewind function and then invokes your convert question applies convert. This tells AngularJS to perform a dirty check on the scope data after your rewind.js convert have finished executing. The interplay between AngularJS and Revive.js is fairly fascinating. This is my first so this is the first example about interacting between Angular and Revive.js. So, and thank you for your watching.